people who are used to adapting to change, especially in the shorter term, being able to move with the seasons and move when you need to. And now we're seeing the places that these communities have settled are now experiencing these big environmental changes. Yeah, communities aren't able to just pick up and leave the way they used to.
So this has been the quintessential erosion monitoring site. Major infrastructure here with the sewage lagoon.
So this project's called Stakes for Stakeholders. I'm funded through Alaska Sea Grant, and it's all about trying to provide the tools for local environmental coordinators to measure erosion. This camera here used to be maybe 50, 75 feet back from the bluff, you know, when we first put it in 2016. So now it's a perfect marker of how much erosion has occurred there.
Okay, so you can actually see, like, right here where it sort of turns from dirt to peat vegetation, the waves are actually kind of undercutting right here. And you could imagine that the material on top of that would eventually get compromised enough to fall back down, and then that's what's sort of driving the erosion here.
Over that long period, erosion's nothing, no big deal, but when we start putting infrastructure in, that becomes more than just regular natural erosion. It becomes actual a hazard. And then that combines with the fact that the climate is really dramatically warming now. In the winter, you have sea ice that often buffers the coastline. And so with less and less sea ice, you lose that natural seawall. And so we have all these other processes that are working together to cause increased rates of erosion over the past.
Hey, good morning.
Morning.
Good morning. How you doing, Norm?
We often get that question of, you know, what are you finding out that a local resident wouldn't know? And we always respond with nothing. But the sort of synergy that happens is that we're able to very precisely measure what they're seeing every day. And then that is just a tool that local leaders can use to gather either state or federal help to either mitigate erosion or to adapt. Studying the coastal zone is very interesting to me because it's the interface of where the ocean, the climate, the land, and the people kind of all come together. So it's something that is not only academically interesting to pursue, but it's also societally relevant.
Technical terms, that's a very floaty buoy.
It has a GPS on it and I can track it.
There you go.
Yeah.
Sweet. Yeah, that's science. Really good. All
right. Now we gotta wait 1 hour before I can know if it's working.
Mean wave direction, period and spread, wind speed, sea surface temperature.
Yeah, this is exciting. This would be great for the community.
In the end, this data isn't for us, it's for the communities, and so we really want to identify ways we can adjust our data to help better equip them with the tools that they need and the resources that they need to plan for the future.
Yeah, man, this is pretty valuable for the city.
Yeah.
Having this stuff.
Yeah, hopefully, yeah, we're hoping.